Welcome back to Pawa Nius. As an energy company, PNG Power Limited is setting the example of becoming energy efficient through the implementation of a pilot project called Promoting Energy Efficiency in the Pacific. The Asian Development Bank co-funded project supported by the International Institute for Energy Conservation is aimed at reducing energy wastage and promoting wise use of energy while minimizing carbon dioxide emissions.
Phase 2 of the project, or simply PEP2 this year, saw PPL install energy-efficient LED or light-emitting diode streetlights at Hohola in Port Moresby and in Alotau, as well as replacing all T8 lights with T5 lamps at the PPL National Office and UPNG's Science Faculty. Both the LED and T5 lamps consume very less electricity, give off less heat and give off more brightness compared to T8 and mercury vapor or MV lamps, says demand side management team leader Bruce Hogger.
I think the main drive in developing this project is it's actually a global concern. As you can see around the world, you know, we have this climate change that is taking place, and one of the significant approaches that the Global Environmental Facility is undertaking is to basically look at ways to adopt and mitigate those or reduce the amount of carbon that we use.
The implementation of PEP2 results in an approximate annual field cost savings of 346,211 kina, fuel reduction of 112,406 litres, carbon dioxide reduction of 294 tonnes, and energy savings of 406,808 kilowatt-hour. PEP2 also requires PNG Power to spearhead awareness on the importance of energy efficiency.
Energy efficiency is not basically in terms of technology, but it may relate to, you know, basic knowledge. You know, for instance, when you go into a shop, the things that you need to look for, you know, like electrical appliances, you look for these energy labels. This is important information that you need to look for when you as a purchaser, when you try to buy goods at our electrical wholesales and outlets like Brian Bell, Courts. It's best you ask them for the energy labels.
PNG Power is encouraging the public and business houses to purchase and use LED and T5 lamps, as well as star-rated appliances, as they are energy efficient and save running costs.
Basically, for the customers, you know, it's a win-win situation for both PNG Power and for PNG Power as a utility and for customers. After you do an audit, you basically identify the where the losses are, energy losses and wastage of energy is, and then when you cut down on these things, you basically reduce the amount of energy that you consume, which turns out to save in your bills.
PNG Power is soon to roll out the energy efficiency project across PNG. Contact your nearest PNG Power office for more information.
The success of any organization, let alone PNG Power Limited, rests almost primarily on how committed they invest in the training of their employees. For PPL, employee training and upskilling has always been a key priority.
This important role is implemented by the Human Resource Department, headed by Andrew Kavanamur, HR Manager, Organization Development.
As you all know, electricity is not a product that we should play around with. It's a highly and risky environment, and training is seen as one of the key deliverables that we should be taking care of and ensuring that our employees are safety conscious because of the risk involved.
Under technical training, PPL employees have benefited in the areas of electrical, mechanical, lines and power station operation trainings, while soft skills and corporate trainings have continued to boost the performance in customer service, administration, time management, problem solving, negotiations, HR and accounting, among many others.
We've done our best so far this year in ensuring that our employees are put through relevant trainings, and the trainings are having an impact on the employees and where they are situated in the organization in terms of performing their functions within each business group.
Most of the trainings are run at the PNG Power College and are not just limited to PPL employees. In addition to the trainings, PPL's graduate development program has provided a career pathway for university graduates, most of whom now hold managerial positions in the company. Classic example being Mr. Kavanamur himself.
The success of this organization depends on the investment that the company puts into training employees. And the big part of that, the responsibility lies with my group in training and in development, in ensuring that all employees of the organization are trained.
He added the PPL's unreserved commitment to employee trainings and graduate development program makes it one of the best employers in the market.
After a break, we'll bring you a public notice on the changes to cash payments of EasyPay units, PPL disconnects ohms of illegal power users, and PPL CEO gives us an insight into the recent executive appointments. Stay with us for the details.